Over 4 years now, full time in our RV, and we've traveled to 32 different states.
32, huh?
Yeah, well, some of them have been winners.
Some of them have not been winners at all.
Not been winners. That's what we're talking about today. We're talking about our bottom three worst states to RV in. Now, this is from our perspective.
Our experience.
And we're only talking about the states that we've been to, because we can't really speak to the ones that we haven't been to.
Correct.
So, here is our list for the states that, not our favorite.
Yeah.
Our three worst states, we're gonna start from the third worst and work our way up to our very least favorite.
Okay.
The very, very worst of the worst.
Okay.
What's third worst?
Third worst, and no offense, not hurting feelings, it's just nothing personal.
We have to name some state.
Yeah.
And there's gonna be people that live there that don't get your feelings hurt.
And it's a beautiful state.
It is.
So it has nothing to do with that.
Nothing personal.
But our third worst is Indiana.
Yes, and there are several reasons why Indiana is the third worst for us. So what are some of the reasons?
Weather. Weather's one of the bad ones
for surprisingly. Surprisingly, there's a high rate of tornadoes in Indiana.
Yeah.
And they have like these little microbursts.
Yeah.
These intense storms that just come out of nowhere in this little concentrated area that just beat the crap out of you and then they're gone.
Yeah, it's crazy.
We had one hit us when we were at the rally.
Yeah.
And we were over in the rally house doing our dinner or whatever it was.
Yeah, last year.
And had our flagpole up and one of the little microbursts hit and bam, bent our flagpole right in half.
Yeah.
And so it was not forecasted. There's nothing you can do to prepare for it. Just hits you out of nowhere.
Yeah, that was crazy.
One of the other reasons is bad roads. Indiana has some pretty bad roads. They do the seam thing.
Yeah.
So you're yeah. And it's just so freaking annoying. Some of those gaps are pretty far, and when they line up with your truck tires and your RV tires, it's just like
constant.
Yeah, it's just so annoying.
Yeah, didn't like that.
All right, what else?
Well, sales tax there. Pretty high.
Second highest sales tax in the U.S. Yes. Second only to California, who has the highest sales tax. The sales tax in Indiana is 7%.
Yeah.
So for RV travelers, if you go into Indiana and you're hanging out for a little bit, and try to do your grocery shopping in another state before you get to Indiana.
If you want to save a couple bucks, yeah.
Yeah. And then the last reason in Indiana.
You take offense to this.
I take significant offense to this. They don't sell alcohol on Sundays. Which I don't understand. It's not a big deal for us.
It's not a big deal.
Because we carry plenty on board.
Yeah.
So we don't really need to go to the liquor store on Sunday.
You just feel you should be able to go any day.
I should be able to go any day.
Any day.
So, I mean, if people really want alcohol, they're going to get it on Saturday and stock up before Sunday. And then, or they're going to buy it on Monday.
It's a religious reservation for the day.
Maybe it has more to do with like the Sabbath and religion than it does with trying to deter. But I just...
Yeah, it's not a turn. It's a religious
thing. It's 2023. It's almost 2024. Let us buy some alcohol. All right, the second worst.
Yes.
Kansas.
Yes.
And there's a couple reasons why Kansas. And now, we lived in Kansas.
We lived in Kansas, so it's nothing personal, Kansas.
Yeah, we were stationed in Kansas in the military for a couple years. I deployed to Iraq twice out of Kansas.
I was in Kansas way longer than you were in Kansas.
But that's not the reason that I hold hostility against Kansas.
No,
nothing
it's not.
Against. So the first thing is just there's just not a lot to see.
No, the scenery there is pretty bland.
Yeah, there's not a lot of landscape. It's just flat. You can drive forever across there. And it doesn't change. So, you know, states like Texas, you got one side where you have some scenery and the other side's flat. Kansas is completely, there's nothing there.
There are minimal attractions to draw you to Kansas anyway.
Yeah.
As far as state parks, national parks, you know, fun stuff to do while you're there.
Yeah. So the folks who are in charge of like tourism and trying to promote Kansas and get people in, they're struggling. They're struggling right now.
Yeah.
Because there's just not a whole lot to do. And no really huge cities. You have Topeka, and then you have Kansas City. But Kansas City is mostly on the Missouri side. All the good stuff's on the Missouri side. Mm-hmm. So you really don't have, you got Wichita, but there's not a lot to do.
Correct.
And because it's so flat and so spread out and so far between major cities, There have been internet issues in Kansas.
We did have a little bit.
Now we have Starlink, so it's not as bad. But if you don't have Starlink, you may struggle with your network.
Yes.
You know, and I don't know which ones work better than others. We have Starlink, and then our backup is T-Mobile Home. When we were in Kansas, we used Verizon, and it worked well in some places for us, and not so well in the others.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, for me, one of the biggest draws of Kansas was, because I had to live it more than you did, the extreme heat and extreme cold.
Yeah.
And that's, extreme wind.
Yeah. Well, the extreme wind is because it's so flat. There's nothing to slow the wind down. So then when you get the extreme hot, for some reason in the summertime, when it's extremely hot, the wind doesn't blow. But then when it gets extremely cold, the wind decides
it's
to pick up.
Yeah.
And there's nowhere to hide. There's nowhere to go.
No.
Now, we don't want to say all negative things about Kansas.
No.
So we want to highlight a couple of the fun things that we've done there.
We have fond memories.
Yeah. So we went to the NASCAR race there.
Yes.
That was our first year full-time on the road. Mm-hmm. Went to the NASCAR race. And that is on the Kansas side. The racetrack
is.
And then we went to the Wizard of Oz Museum.
Yes.
Now, we went there several years ago when we were stationed there.
Mm-hmm.
And it was fun to go back.
It
had changed a little bit. There was some more stuff in there. And it was really, really cool.
Yeah.
Who don't like the Wizard of Oz?
I know. Come on.
But I will tell you this, though. We don't watch the Wizard of Oz in our house. And there's one reason why. Is because we can't. Because if we watch the Wizard of Oz, Leslie will say every line from every character through the entire movie. She knows the entire movie.
Seen it once or twice.
So I'm like, if we're going to sit here and watch the Wizard of Oz, you have to sit quietly and just enjoy the show.
You know how hard that is to sit there and not sing?
So we love you, Kansas.
Yes.
But you're the second worst.
Yes. All right. So we saved the best for last.
We saved the worst for last.
And that's true. We saved the worst for last. And it's no big shocker to most people.
Now.
Why this is the worst. But our worst state is, of course, California.
It was easy to pick the worst.
It was.
There's lots and lots of reasons why. We will start off with money. It costs a lot to live, travel, pass through, do anything in California.
Everything's expensive. There's nothing cheap.
The gas prices are just ridiculous, especially for folks like us who have to use diesel.
Yes.
The cost of living, even though you're only temporarily living there, the cost of living, groceries.
It was almost double.
Everything you buy, and we already mentioned that they have the highest sales tax rate in the country. So it just restricts your exploration bubble.
Yes. And you have to expand your budget for while you're there.
Or plan for, you know, if you're going to California, plan.
Yes. Plan well. The next thing I would say that's a con to California is the road restrictions.
Yeah, they have a lot of roads where certain length vehicles can't go. And we're one of those vehicles. Along the coast, a lot of the coastal highways have restrictions because they have tight curves and switchbacks. And so then you have to take alternate routes around mountains sometimes to get to places. So
there's
it's kind of
no
hard.
Short, sweet direction to A to B.
Yeah. And then a lot of times in a lot of areas in California, the way to get there is the way. There's not another way. So if that way is jammed up, you're just jammed up.
Exactly.
And they also have emission restrictions.
Yes. And it's getting worse.
Yeah, so they have restrictions on running any kind of gas engine, small two-cycle engines.
Yes.
Generators is a big deal for RVers.
Yeah.
I mean, they're even starting to restrict you to be able to even use, like, leaf blowers to blow off your site or your roof.
Yeah.
So it's a little crazy out in California.
Making it less desirable to go hang out.
Yeah.
Okay, third con, I would say, would be the natural disasters that go with California. You've got your wildfires, you've got earthquakes, which doesn't totally ruin your experience in California.
No, we've experienced an earthquake in California, and being in an RV is probably one of the best places to be in an
RV. It was actually a benefit to be. But the wildfires disrupted our travels so much.
It canceled several of our plans. We were supposed to go to Tahoe, couldn't go there. We were supposed to go to the Redwoods, couldn't go there. We had to get rerouted. We almost got trapped in a spot for a time because one of the fires almost jumped the roads and trapped us. So it is a little discouraging. You kind of have to plan your trip to California around wildfire season.
Yeah.
So
really.
But
with all that said,
California's got some good stuff.
It is a gorgeous state.
It
oh
is
my
beautiful.
God. I
the
loved
scenery,
it.
The landscape is just beautiful. We love it out there.
The weather is perfect.
Yeah. Year round, almost anywhere, except for, like, you know, Northern California. It gets
when
cold,
get
some snow and stuff.
Yeah.
But it's still beautiful out there.
They have wonderful national park access. and attractions in general. If you want to go to Disneyland,
there's a
stuff
ton
like that,
of stuff to go do in California. Not a shortage of stuff to do, but the stuff to do
is
pricey.
So
yeah, budget for it.
Yeah.
Well, that's it. That's our worst three.
So far.
So far, and I'm sure there's some worse ones out there.
Yeah.
So out of all the ones that you've been to, leave us a comment. Let us know if there's ones that you've been to, how bad they are, and why you think they're the worst.